There's a strategy among some birds to avoid all the work of raising their chicks. Birds like cowbirds and cuckoos and indigo birds and whydahs will find a nest, lay their own eggs inside of it, and let another bird do all the hard work of raising their chicks. Parenting speedrun. When the original nest owner returns, they sit on all the eggs, including the new one. Then when the eggs hatch, they feed all the chicks and raise them until they grow up and fly away. This is called brood parasitism. The brood parasite benefits from all the hard work of the so-called host species. It's also one of the most interesting areas of bird study, because hosts and parasites are engaged in an arms race, trying to out-evolve each other. So let's see what happens when evolution fights evolution. Cuckoo eggs are laid every 2 days. It only took 1 day to make the egg, but by incubating the egg internally, the cuckoo mother gives her chick a 1 day head start to hatch before any competing host eggs. Cowbirds take a different strategy. Their chicks develop faster inside the egg, letting them hatch earlier than host eggs. The baby cowbird is blind and featherless, but it can start begging for food and grow faster than its siblings. When some cuckoos hatch, the chick starts pushing itself around the nest, struggling until it pushes all the other eggs out onto the ground. As the only remaining chick, the baby cuckoo gets all the attention of the host parents. Honey guide chicks have a more active way to ensure their solitude. The chick has a pair of spikes on its beak that it uses to destroy all other eggs and chicks in the nest. These adaptations mean that there is an intense pressure for the host to remove brood parasites. For some birds, if they notice that there's a new egg in their nest, they'll simply push it out onto the ground or break the egg. But some cuckoo and cowbird species have extra thick eggshells that the host may not be able to break. If the hosts can't push the egg out of the nest, then they will have a rogue chick to feed. Cowbird females, having left their eggs for another bird to raise, will still stop by to check on their development. If their egg is missing, the cowbird female may destroy the host nest. For this reason, some host birds will just abandon the whole nest if a foreign egg is present. Better to just start over than deal with a brood parasite. Once the eggs hatch, the brood parasites have additional ways to succeed. A cuckoo egg deposited in a reed warbler nest hatches a chick that is twice as large as a reed warbler chick. The baby cuckoo will eventually grow to be 6 times the weight of its host parents. But the cuckoo chick makes a call that sounds like a nest full of hungry reed warbler chicks. Its host parents provide 4 times as much food as they would for any of their own chicks. Evolution is definitely helping out the cuckoo in this case. Hosts around the world have come up with different defenses. Village weavers weave their nests out of grasses. When they are done, the nest is completely enclosed. And the nests have a long, long entrance tube that is exactly the right size for the weaver that made the nest. This keeps out predators, and it also keeps out brood parasites. Weavers also establish a neighborhood watch. If any predators or brood parasites approach, the alarm is sounded, and the birds work together to harass the invader. This strategy seems to be working for now. Some birds evolved speckled eggs as a way to fight brood parasites. Their own eggs have a unique pattern, so no other bird can lay eggs that match. The tawny-flanked Prenia has eggs which can be red, brown, white, or blue, and they can have speckles or lines, and the size and density of markings can change. Each tawny-flanked Prenia has a unique signature of eggs, and the females pay attention to these markings to identify any invaders. Tawny-flanked Prenia brood parasites are adapting. Cuckoo finches are already able to lay the different colors of eggs and choose nests with eggs that are similar in color to their own. Cuckoos are also specializing that way. There are different genties of cuckoos that lay different styles of egg. Cuckoos lay eggs in the nests that match their own eggs. Hosts have a range of skills in identifying parasitic eggs. There are some hosts that have not yet evolved to detect cuckoo eggs, like the dunnock. There are other hosts that are incredible at recognizing foreign eggs, and they remove any eggs they don't recognize. Fairy wrens have an incubation call that they repeat on average every 4 minutes from day 9 to day 16 of incubation. The call contains a password, which is unique to each female. When the horse-felled bronze cuckoo lays its eggs in the nest on day 12, its developing chicks do not hear the password as much. When the eggs hatch, the fairy wren chicks use the password in their begging calls, leading to high rates of recognition for their own chicks. That said, fairy wrens still raise about 40% of the horse-felled bronze cuckoo chicks that are deposited in their nests, meaning that they are putting selective pressure on the population of cuckoos to be increasingly good at fooling their hosts. Evolution has given the fairy wren a temporary advantage. The firefinch has an interesting strategy to identify its chicks. Their chicks have a patterned mouth with a light inner surface and three large black spots at the top, a white tongue, magenta inner cheek, and four white beads on the corners of their mouths. It's a vibrant pattern, which lets the parents know that they are caring for their own chicks. Unmistakable. Except if there's an indigo bird chick in the nest, which has almost exactly the same pattern. Evolution of a defense leads to evolution of a counter-offense. This is all an amazing part of bird life, of which many people are unaware. Adaptation and counter-adaptation in a battle that quietly takes place every egg-laying season. There is even more that we didn't talk about in this video, and there is more out there to discover. I don't want the parasites to go extinct, but I'm always rooting for the host species in this evolutionary arms race. I think it's obvious that the winner in this is evolution, and the people who study it. There's evolution and counter-evolution and counter-counter-evolution in a high-stakes game for survival. We can't predict how evolution will shape things over time, but we can predict that this will be an interesting area of study for us and future generations. Thanks for taking the time to learn about birds today. You can keep evolving your knowledge about birds by subscribing. If you'd like to support the channel, you can support us on Patreon or as a channel member. Thanks for stopping by this week to learn what makes life awesome.